Well, welcome everybody to a Church for All Souls, the Metropolitan Community Church of the Coachella Valley. Absolutely. It's nice to have some enthusiasm here. We are being live streamed. Now, usually our live stream has between 2,000 and 3,000 viewers during the course of the week. So if they all decide to turn up for church, we're in trouble, but it hasn't happened thus far. However, after seeing what we have on offer today, that might change. So if you hear about civil disruption in Cathedral City in the coming weeks, and this is probably what it's like. I'm not going to go on forever. I'm just going to say that it is an absolute thrill to have the lovely Dan Miller with us. Yeah. As well as various luminaries, panjandrums, and muckamucks of the organ world. And I'd like to especially thank Carol Picard, our organist, and the extraordinary Patty Dean Walford for putting on our preception, which I think everyone would admit is glorious. And I'd like to ask the lovely Dan to come forward.
Well, thank you so much, and thank you for coming this afternoon. And those who are watching on live stream, thank you very much. This is a very momentous occasion for me to play this beautiful organ and to celebrate it with you. Tomorrow morning in worship, we're going to enjoy the dedication of this organ. And I'm really looking forward to playing in worship tomorrow morning as much as I am for this concert this afternoon. Thank you very much, and there are quite a few wonderful friends, dignitaries in the organ world here, and I was telling a friend here that coming here to play is almost like a family reunion. So it's great to see you all, and thank you for coming. And I'll make new friends here too, I'm sure. This afternoon's concert is not an academic recital. Yes, I could play one of those if I was at a university, but we are at a church, and I prefer to play music that the people would appreciate, especially to sacrifice to make this organ happen. So you're going to hear music. Yes, you will hear some music of the masters, but you will hear other music that you may recognize, and music that you might think, is that really coming from an organ? But in this case, yes it is, because the organs of this year, this day, can play far more than just the typical pipe organ. We can go outside of the box if the box is the pipe organ, and you will hear that. So we open with Trumpet Voluntary, which is not the typical Trumpet Voluntary you might think from weddings and so forth. This is by an English composer, John Stanley.
Thank you.
So you heard already a little bit of this organ going outside of the pipe organ realm. We are hearing pipes. This organ has samples recorded, high definition digital recording of pipes from organs from around the world. But we also have samples of orchestral instruments. And one of them you heard was that trumpet, which is amazing, so fun. Well, the next piece is called Benedictus. This is not the benediction, the concert is not over, but this is a beautiful piece. And there's a subtitle, it's called I Bring You Peace, I Bring You Rest by Alec Rowley. And this starts with the organ pretty quiet, but then it builds to full organ, comes back down several times, and it's a beautiful display of what this beautiful organ can do. Benedictus.
Thank you.
Now we're going to hear probably the most famous organ music ever known. Okay. Yeah. And in fact, it's so famous that sometimes this is the ringtone in some cell phones. And if you haven't silenced your cell phone yet, I ask you to do that so we don't have any duets this afternoon, okay? Toccata and Fuga D minor, written by my hero, J.S.B. And why is he my hero? Because this man of God has written such a great amount of music for the church and for the organ. And Toccata and Fuga D minor, well, through the years, there's been arguments by scholars if Bach really wrote this. But the research that I found is that some of those scholars who thought, no, he didn't write it, they changed their minds. Said, yeah, they think that he did. And with all of Bach's music, he wrote on the first page, Soli Deo Gloria, to God's glory alone. So I think Bach would be quite upset if he knew that today this music is associated with evil or haunted houses or scary things, you know? Because actually Bach based this music on a hymn that's still in Lutheran hymnals today. And that hymn is We All Believe in One God. It is in a plain chant form. It's not a metric type of a hymn, and it sounds like this. So you understand, you can hear that, right? So, fasten your seatbelts. Here we go with Toccata and Fuga D minor. Thank you. Carol, I didn't hurt it. It's not even warm. We're good. You know? She's a sweetheart, I tell you. Well, we're going to give our ears a rest now and hear the very famous Adagio for Strings. When you hear this, you may, you know, come, you may, your mind may bring images of, you know, a movie or some remembrance of where you've heard this before, or maybe you may associate it with a dear friend's departing, but it is just beautiful music, so please enjoy Adagio for Strings. Thank you. Now for some Mendelssohn. Mendelssohn is another hero of mine. He wrote great music. He was a proponent of all the Bach's music. He really, Bach wasn't that well known back then, and Mendelssohn really made the world know about this amazing composer. But Mendelssohn himself was amazing too. He wrote a lot of great music, and this one I happened to choose because I like it. I hope that's a good reason for you. I did some research, and one person said that this is based on an improvisation that Mendelssohn did for his sister's wedding. The opening is this grand music, and this music is, this sonata is like in three sections, basically, or four, depending on how, whatever you want to count it. So it opens with this grand and glorious music. That comes to an end, and then begins a fugue, okay? And it's in a minor key. The beginning's in major key, now we're in a minor key, and we hear the melody, you know, approach, and then another hand, another, and then in the feet, in the pedals, Mendelssohn has the melody of an old Lutheran hymn of "Out of the Depths I Cry to Thee." So I don't know how that's related to a wedding, but you can come to your own conclusion there, okay? But this beautiful fugue with the melody and the pedal comes back to this glorious music of the wedding. And that comes to a big ending, and you think, oh yeah, the music's over, yay. No, it's not over yet. There's another movement after that that's very quiet. So here we have Sonata number 3 in A major, very boring title, by Felix Mendelssohn.
Thank you.
right. That's right, Bobby. Well, I'd like to play now two wonderful American tunes to honor those in this room who have served our country, or members of your family who have served or are serving our country locally, nationally, internationally. Thank you for your service. We're going to hear the amazing, it sounds so good on this organ too, the Copland Fanfare for the Common Man, followed by the Navy Hymn. Now, the Navy Hymn has another title, Eternal Father, Strong to Save. And those of you who know this hymn know that it's not just for the Navy. It's a prayer for all those in service, because the lyrics refer to those on land, in the air, and in the sea. And this music I arranged, it begins as a prayer, but then it changes slightly. It goes into a minor key. We're going to hear little snippets of the service melodies, Off We Go Into the Wild Blue Yonder and Anchors Away and all that kind of thing. But in a minor key, it's kind of in a march, and this represents the danger that our men and women face and have faced. And so the music grows in intensity, and it gets busier and busier, and we even hear a little bit of A Mighty Fortress Is Our God as a prayer of protection for these people. And it culminates with this glorious finale, and the pedals are going crazy, the feet are going crazy on the pedals. We almost need a fire extinguisher nearby. But please enjoy, and thank you again for your service.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, and thank you again for your service and that of your family and your friends. Well, we're going to have a little fun now. Okay, I've been having fun all afternoon, but this is a little audience participation time. I'd like to know, does anyone here have a birthday this year? All right. And some of you, my friends, have had some significant birthdays this year, too, some milestones. Well, this music is for you. We're going to hear Happy Birthday, deranged in the style of several composers. So please enjoy and have fun, and here we go. Thank you. Well, yeah. Say what? I didn't cheat. I didn't have enough arms. Okay. Now Carol could see really close. Maybe some of you didn't see. I took advantage of the technology in this organ of the record and playback system, because the last part, you know, sometimes I wish I was an octopus. I could play more things. But I pre-recorded two hands and two feet and pushed the button at the right time so I could play the piccolo part live. So, this has everything in it, the honky-tonk piano and the Wurlitzer, and all, it's all there. It's so fun. Well, we are at the conclusion of the concert, and earlier I played probably the most famous organ music. Well, maybe this next piece would be the second most famous organ music. It's commonly known as the Vidor Toccata, and it's a great, great music. It's a great workout for the organist, too. And it's, you know, heard for concerts and for weddings, and it could be the, commonly it's the postlude for Easter Sunday in houses of worship around the world. And it sounds great on this organ. So, thank you again, and here, before I start playing, I just wanted to remind you that I brought some CDs with me. They're in the back room, and Carol is, Clarice is helping with the table back there. And these CDs, some of them were recorded on Rogers organs, and some of them were recorded on the 13th largest pipe organ in the world, where I served at Calvary Church in Charlotte, North Carolina, for a number of years. That organ has 5 manuals, 205 ranks, 11,499 pipes. I counted every one, I know. So there's CDs back there of some of the music you heard today, and others are some Christmas tunes back there. Everything's $10. And the purpose of those CDs is to, for a very worthy cause, is to help needy children, my grandkids. So. So please support us, okay? All right, here we go. There we go. Thank you.
a wonderful afternoon. Thank you so much indeed. When I was a little boy at the Blackpool Tower in Northern England listening to the Mighty Wurlitzer, I never dreamt that one day I'd have one in my own church. My goodness. So please thank you everyone for coming, Panjandrums and Muckamucks and everyone else, and please do buy as many CDs as you can, and you also will see a free will offering basket on the stand where you got your programs from. So please enjoy and spend lots of money. And tomorrow we have service at 10 a.m. in the morning, and of course we will have the lovely Dan Miller playing with us again. Thank you again. I'll see you tomorrow.